Our next guest has successfully embraced the digital challenges of working during a pandemic, even going viral on TikTok. Senior presenter at Australian Effect Training, Dr. Jo Isaac, joins us live now. Good morning,
Thank
Dr.
So
Jo.
Much,
Thanks for joining
Good morning.
Us. Look, it's been a really challenging 6 months in particular for a lot of businesses having to pivot to a remote model. Tell us about some of the challenges that have come through with that.
Well, COVID-19, I think overseas and in many countries, we're all living the same challenges. For us, for Australian Effect, we have faced the uncertainty to manage 6 offices in 6 different countries with a large number of educators. I consider this one of the top 2 challenges, with the other one being the tight timelines, having to synchronize all these educators and move our workshops from face-to-face, predominantly in many countries, all of a sudden to webinars and actually run through with that in 4 weeks has been one of the most difficult times I have ever faced. And I have to admit, we've never really anticipated something like this. And that delivery, when you move from face-to-face to webinar and the engagement, does really make a big difference.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think one of the things that, you know, we have seen in such great detail is the real, you know, concern around unemployment and that shift in skills that's needed as we move forward. What are your suggestions when it comes to job security and upskilling as we move forward?
Very good question. And COVID-19 has presented very different type of skill sets that a lot of people have to be ready to move with that traction. And one of those skills is absolute resilience. Back in the day, we didn't have that much high resilience. At the moment, it is required to be extremely resilient, your adaptability to change and operating in uncertainty times, to be comfortable with the uncomfortable. As I always say, you have to be comfortable with the uncomfortable to grow. And there's no more challenging times that will put this to the test more than COVID-19.
Well, I mean, speaking of social media as well, talk to us about your tactic during COVID and how you managed to go viral on TikTok.
Well, social media, the only thing that has been going positively in COVID-19, as you know, people are at home. There's a lot of time that has been saved from commuting from the workplace to the house, or for those people who are studying. And there's so many people online. In my case, I have never been live supporting people, answering questions and just chilling together and keeping them company, raising that mental health awareness. Like, I have never done this before in that frequency. I used to go live on YouTube once a month. Now I go live on YouTube once a week, and on TikTok and on Instagram and Facebook. What the people are currently using, because the people are online, they're using vicious hooking techniques. And that's exactly one of the most powerful tips that a lot of people are using now. It's that 5 seconds when you hook your viewers. They actually know me on TikTok by the guy that can help you read minds. And because of, we're talking about brain analysis and eye detection and movement, body language analysis, we've taken some snippets from those ones talking about behaviors and auditory and kinesthetic types and how to read their body language and eye movements. When that went on TikTok, has over 1.2 million on one video and then another couple of million on other videos. Australia is actually the mid-range terms of followers compared to the US, where I had the majority of the people coming from. And I think this is how we need to connect in times like this, especially in Melbourne with the isolation. I mean, I'm in Sydney. The situation is not as critical as Melbourne. To keep each other company and stay in touch, I think it's extremely important.
Well, I mean, you mentioned that TikTok is a relatively new platform, but my gosh, have we heard a lot about it, particularly over the last 6 months, and in regards to security concerns. From that point of view, do you think that businesses are quite reluctant to use it as a tool?
Well, it appears to be in the very beginning. I think things now might take a change after Scott Morrison has announced that in Australia, we don't see any problems, we don't see any challenges, and we're not going to follow some other countries that raise those concerns. And I think some businesses are becoming more open to it. At Australian Effect, we are using TikTok, and a lot of the staff members are using it, and we don't have any concerns from our IT team or security, cybersecurity specialists that they have raised so far. So I guess at least from our business and our organization point of view, we are okay with that. And I think a lot of people will be joining in, because TikTok now has pushed a lot of opportunities for people to do direct marketing through the platform, TikTok Business. And instead of spending money on advertising, they're actually making TikToks and introducing their business and their models and their way of fun at work through TikTok.
Well, Dr. Jo, thank you so much for joining us on the program this morning. Appreciate your time.
Pleasure. Thank you.